Welcome back. Let's take a look at the domestic pharmaceutical market. It slowed down to a growth of just 2% in FY21 after posting an 8 to 10% compounded growth for the preceding 5 years between FY16 to FY20. My colleague Ekta Batra takes a deep dive into the domestic pharmaceutical market to assess why did it slow down, especially in a year of COVID-19 related sales, and what is the estimate for growth going forward.
The domestic Indian pharma market is estimated to be close to around $20 billion in terms of size. From FY16 to FY20, the domestic drug market is estimated to have grown 8 to 10% CAGR. This growth has come despite headwinds such as price control as well as introduction of generic drugs from both the government as well as private companies. Company-wise, most major pharma companies have a significant exposure to the Indian market, with the likes of Sun, Cipla and Cadila enjoying a significant market share. However, the Indian pharma market, while having grown between FY16 to FY20, slowed down to just a 2% growth in FY21. Surprising, because this was the year of COVID-19 sales. However, the slowdown was mainly due to both the acute as well as the chronic portfolio of drugs facing headwinds. Acute portfolio of drugs such as anti-infectives slowed due to lower footfalls in hospitals, clinics, restricted mobility such as schools and offices being closed, and similarly the chronic segment slowed due to lower addition of newer patients and prescriptions as many doctor clinics were closed as well. While COVID-19 related portfolio of drugs aided some companies and will especially in Q1 of FY22, the stupendous growth in the IPM or the Indian pharma market seen in April and May 2021 was mainly due to a low base, hence a one-off. And as you can see, June sales have already tapered down. However, analysts are still bullish on the Indian pharma market. Estimates are that the market will grow between 15 to 17% in FY22, aided by a low base, yes. But the positives for the Indian pharma market story include increasing drug use, growth in tier 2 and tier 3 markets, and overall better cash generation. Some also think it's a better bet than the US due to price stability as compared to US generics. Lastly, while growth is expected to continue, companies too are becoming agile. They are focusing on cutting the fat, i.e. rationalizing existing brands, not hiring new market reps, and focusing on digital initiatives as well as growing the wellness or the preventive segment.
All right, so that was an insightful analysis broken down by Ekta. She's recorded this earlier, of course, and we're playing you the key, analysis in the domestic pharmaceutical market. But to take this point further, and how should one, approach their investment in this space, we have Aditya Khemka, the fund manager at InCred Financial Services, joining us now. He specializes in the pharmaceutical space as well. Aditya, thanks a lot for joining in. Like Ekta said, the domestic pharmaceutical market has slowed down in FY21. But traditionally, pharma investing in India, the secondary markets, has been largely export-oriented. Do you think, the international market growth is good enough for one to not change that thesis and continue to grow, or maybe take a look at their portfolio again because the domestic market is slowing down?
So thanks for having me. To respond to your question, basically, there are companies which are conglomerates, pharma companies in India are conglomerates. And we at InCred, we clearly always bifurcate the companies into what they are more focused on. Is it exports? Is it domestic? And where is the strength? Where is the core competency of the company? And our perspective has been, for the portfolio that we manage, the perspective has been to invest in those companies which are more focused on the Indian healthcare space, because we feel the growth there can be substantially better quality growth than the growth that these companies can achieve in the export markets. And the key differentiation between the two being branding, because in branding, in the Indian healthcare space, you're allowed to brand your products, whereas in the export space, especially the regulated markets, you're not allowed to brand your products. And branding is what protects your pricing in the Indian market. And because you are unbranded in the export space, you do not have any pricing levers. In fact, you're a price taker and not a price maker. So I believe that, at InCred, we believe that we will continue to invest in companies which are more domestic oriented, because we feel that the profitability and the growth there is far more sustainable than it is for the regulated export markets.
Right, so then in that case, if you could drill it down to individual stocks, if you can, what are the companies that you're backing, and What do you think would lead growth in the next few years, and would it be more than the 8 to 10% compounding that had happened in the preceding 5 years?
So we are obviously focused more on those companies which have higher domestic exports, higher domestic sales versus export sales. And you know, we've seen that the Indian market growth rate can accelerate in the future, provided that the two initiatives that the government has announced, one is Ayushman Bharat, and the other is the capital expenditure on creating primary healthcare infrastructure of 64,000 crores over the next 6 years. The fact is that you know, there's a large population of the Indian market which hasn't been a part of the pharma market because they didn't have accessibility, or they didn't have affordability, or they didn't have both. Now we have Ayushman Bharat being rolled out in India, where the government is going to give 10 crore families, that's about 40, 45 crore individuals, healthcare insurance of 5 lakh rupees each for free. So that should take care of affordability. And then you have the other initiative of 64,000 crore rupees in CapEx for primary healthcare centers. Now that should take care of accessibility. So, you know, as we look forward for the next 5 to 10 years, we believe that the growth rate in the Indian market can significantly improve, and the quality of growth can be more volume driven than be price driven, you know. And therefore, we are extremely, you know, optimistic about the future of the domestic pharma market.
Okay. Aditya, hi, welcome to the show. I just wanted your thoughts on what your portfolio would then look like. Would you then choose maybe a company which has a 100% or majority focus on the domestic pharma market vis-à-vis having more diversification towards exports?
That's true. And if you look at the portfolio that we manage at Incred Healthcare PMS, we have about a third of the portfolio deployed in companies which get a lion's share of their revenue and profit from the domestic market, whereas we have only 10 to 12% of the portfolio in companies where they derive a significant portion of their profits and cash flow from the export markets. So clearly, and you know, the balance one third we have in contract manufacturing businesses, where we believe there is significant growth opportunity given the China plus one playing out. And we have about 10 to 15% in hospitals and diagnostics because they are also, in our view, a COVID recovery play. So that's how our portfolio is bifurcated between these four segments.
But how long do you expect this entire COVID theme to probably even play out for companies?
So look, COVID has two aspects to it. One is obviously the treatment drugs, where you have your favipiravir, you have your you know, other drugs which are being prescribed, HCQS being prescribed, ivermectin, and the other aspect is vaccination. As you know, vaccinations keep going up, right? As these vaccination numbers keep improving for our economy, the COVID treatment drug sales will potentially fall, may potentially fall, because you know, people who are vaccinated may not actually get infected, and given the efficacy of these vaccines, that's a understanding that we have. And secondly, in terms of the vaccination itself, there are companies which have tie-ups, and there is one company which has its own technology. So the economics for both of these kind of companies would be different, because those who have tie-ups will have to pay a significant royalty to the company from whom they're in licensing the technology of the vaccine. And the company which has its own technology will take the entire share. Having said that, the timing of entry into the market also matters. So if you were amongst the first guys to enter the vaccine market in India, you would definitely have a lion's share of the volume. And if you're a later entrant, you'll have a very small share of the volume. So I don't expect, or actually, we at Incred, we don't expect COVID to be a 5 or 10 year opportunity. Yes, it can be a year or two cash flow, but that cash flow will be fast diminishing, you know, as the vaccination drive improves. And then, you know, there will be, hopefully, you know, we'll be COVID free as a country, and there'll be very few cases.
Okay. But Aditya, you know, the other point is that if you then had to choose between pharmaceuticals and you had to choose between diagnostics and hospitals or healthcare, then which one would you choose in terms of your portfolio? Which sector between these two would you be probably more bullish on when it comes to maybe a domestic play?
Sure. These are two different sort of these apples and oranges, right? So we have both in our portfolio, both have their own pieces, both have their own advantages. Diagnostics and hospitals are probably more of a COVID recovery play, where, you know, as the COVID subsides, hospitals can start doing the general surgeries, which have not been happening because of COVID, because patients have not been stepping out of their homes. They have been postponing surgeries. And same for diagnostics. Many diagnostic procedures which are, you know, optional in nature or discretionary in nature haven't really happened. So that will come back as COVID subsides. Same similarly on the pharmaceutical side, you have companies which are acute heavy, right, which have products which are used in acute treatment. Now, the acute treatment will again come back, you know, as COVID subsides, because people start stepping out of their homes, they start getting infected, they start having fever, and, you know, those drugs just begin to sell again. So these are both, you know, they both have their own merits. In terms of our portfolio, we have 33% of the portfolio in companies which are more domestic pharma oriented, and we have 15% of the portfolio in hospital and diagnostics put together. So I hope that gives you a sense of, you know, where we are on that.
Okay. All right, Aditya. It's a pleasure talking to you. Thank you very much for joining in and giving us all of that perspective with regards to the domestic pharmaceutical industry, what kind of growth you're expecting and what the growth pattern would be probably compared to the exports as well. We need to take a short break now, but up next, Prakash Gaba will join in on the technical. Stay tuned.